We are going to discuss question number 5.27, and in this question it is given to you, a helicopter of mass 1000 kilogram rises with a vertical acceleration of 15 meter per second square. Clear? The crew and passenger having total weight 300 kg. Now we have to find magnitude and the direction of the three parts. Clear? So now let us try to understand first given situation. Let's suppose here we have this helicopter. Let's suppose I am just drawing like this, clear? Because our objective here is to understand only the question. So let's suppose I am saying this is helicopter. Let's suppose this is helicopter, clear? And a helicopter of mass 1000 kilogram. So capital M is given to you. This is 1000 kilogram. It rises with a vertical acceleration of 15 meter per second square. So I can see this acceleration we have 15 meter per second square. Clear? Now in this helicopter we have crew and passengers. So let's suppose here we have crew. Clear? And let's suppose here we have passenger also. Clear? Okay. And having total mass, we can say, let's suppose I am total inside, this is given 300 kilogram. Clear? Clear? Now we have to find number one. Force on the floor by crew and passenger. Clear? So what is total force exerted by this crew and passenger? So how can we solve it? So first of all, let's suppose I am assuming this crew and the passenger as a system. Clear? So I can say total weight of this system we have 300 g. Clear? Now we know helicopter is going in vertical upward direction with acceleration 15 meter per second square. Clear? And definitely when force exerted, this is 300 g. So let's suppose this is action. So at the same time we can say we have reaction also. Clear? So how can we write net force in a vertical upward direction? I can say this is R minus 300 g. This should be equal to, I can say, 300 into acceleration, because this time our system is crew and passenger. Clear? So now I can write here force on the floor by crew and passenger. I can say this is 300 common. This is G plus A. Value of G. Value of G is not given to you. So let's suppose I am taking here, this is 10. So 300 and this is 10 plus 15. Clear? We can say this is becomes 25. So 25 multiply 300. I can say 75 and this is Newton. Clear? So we can say this is a force exerted by crew and passenger on a floor. Clear, everyone? Now, in second part, it is given action of a rotor of the helicopter on surrounding air. Now listen carefully. So whenever we are talking about action of a helicopter or rotor, so you can see, let's suppose now we are observing from outside. Now we have the whole system. Whole system means what? Now we will take mass of helicopter as well as mass of crew and passenger also into consideration. Clear? Same equation now I will apply. R minus. But here I will also write one more term, that is 1000 g. Clear? So I can say this is 1300 g, and this should be given by 1300 multiply, I can say 15. Clear? So from here you can say R, this is given by, I can take 1300 common, this is G plus 15. Clear? Value of G I am taking, this is 10. So 10 plus 15, this is 25. So 1300 multiply 25. So we can say this is 0, 0. So we can say, so if you multiply 25 with 3, you can say this is 75. We have 7. So this is 3, 2. Clear? So we can say this is value of reaction, or we can say this is action of a rotor on helicopter on the surrounding air. This is given by 32500 newton. Clear? So now we can say this rotor is exerting this much amount of force on the surrounding air. At the same time, what is happening? Surrounding air is also exerting same force on a rotor. Clear? Because every action has an opposite reaction. So if we talk about part C, force on helicopter due to surrounding air, this is also given by 32500 newton. Clear? If you are assuming this as action, we can say this is reaction. Clear, everyone? If we are assuming this as action, this is reaction. Clear to everyone? So this is all about this question.